Hello again, everybody, and welcome to Mid-South Wrestling, another exciting hour of the number one sports wrestling television program in the country. I'm Jim Ross, and I'll be your host for all the action for the next 60 minutes. And here to provide our commentary with our color is analyst Joel Watts. And Joel, we've got an exciting card. Grizzly Smith has got a lot of the top names in wrestling here this week, and of course, we've got a tremendous TV main event.
We sure do. For our TV main event today, we're going to have Terry Taylor against Hercules Hernandez for the television title. Both tremendous athletes, Jim.
Well, I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to come up just a little bit later in wrestling. You're also going to see Brickhouse Brown and Johnny Mantell teaming up. Magnum TA, the North American champion, is here. The Midnight Express, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions will be in action. Exotic Adrian Street will be here also. You know, ladies and gentlemen, last week when I was ring announcing here on Mid-South Wrestling, I met a man very auspiciously by the name of Master G. Master G came into the ring and he introduced himself to Hacksaw Butch Reed rather abruptly. Let's join the closing moments of that match.
Wait just a second.
Hey, what is this? Who is this, man?
Wait a minute.
That's bad.
Wait a minute. What are you doing?
I see you, sucker, and I'm just time to go.
What are you doing here? What are you doing here?
I'm here to beat Bruce Lee.
I'm here to break ass back. Who you come here to whoop me, boy? You got to be a fool, sucker.
Oh, boy, Pierce, this is not an official bout. I don't know what's happening, but there's a stallion out there, and he's got tape all the way up to his elbow. And he's hammering Butch Reed.
He put him down, Bill, and it's not Brickhouse Brown, but mercy, another one.
It's not Brickhouse Brown, but it's Butch Reed getting punished out there. I don't know the guy. I've never seen him, but he looks like he's awesome. He has laid Butch Reed's head wide open. The crimson is flowing. And, of course, when you got those fists taped, you can flat pack a wallop. The one thing the tape does is it keeps your hand from getting broken. And then he just used some cowboy boots, and any good old cowboy knows what they can do when you're talking street style. And he's just, I don't know this guy. He just walked in calm and cool and collected. It's just like a mafia man coming in with something in his briefcase. He had that coat folded over it, and right, he's got a club on his right hand.
Well, Jim Ross asked him what he was doing here, and he said he came to beat Hacksaw Butch Reed, and he hadn't slackened at all.
Well, Ronnie West is powerless to help. I hope the Grizzly Smith sends another referee down. We got to get some order here. We don't know what's happening, but Butch Reed is getting a severe whipping. Butch Reed just got pulled right out of the ring. This man just destroyed the King of Mid-South. This man is just delivered. He's like ice. Calm and cool and collected, boy. It's like a day at the office.
At this point, we had no idea who Master G was other than he was one bad dude. But I had the opportunity to talk to Master G a few moments after that incident with Hacksaw Butch Reed. And here's what he had to say. Ladies and gentlemen, after what has just happened here on Mid-South Wrestling, I feel it's opportune to talk to this man. And obviously, first of all, who are you?
Well, I'm known as Master G. I've been over in Japan, New Zealand, Australia, and for the last 5 years, all I could hear is Mid-South Wrestling, Dick Murdoch, Mid-South Wrestling, the Samoans. You go to the Mid-South Wrestling, you see all kind of great top stars. I was in New York City tonight. I was supposed to wrestle in Madison Square Garden. I turned down a $5,000 contract today to come here and wick a nickel worth of booty. Now, I'm gonna tell you something. Bruce Reed, I talked to Junkyard Dog tonight. You got him scared to come back here. I've been traveling all over the world. I haven't had a chance to come to the United States. This is my first time here in over 10 years, and I come here to build a home. Now, you ran the Junkyard Dog out, that's good. You can't run this dog out. I'm here to stay, and I'm here to whoop a whole lot of behind, and I'm starting with the top dog, and that's Hacksaw Reed, and I'm working my way down. And by the time I get through with this place right here, it's going to be a clean place.
Well, there you hear the comments. He says his name's Master G, and he did take care of some serious business with Hacksaw Butch Reed.
Well, Jim, I believe you were right when you said that Master G is one bad dude. And what, as one of our great presidents was said, he speaks softly and carries a big stick.
A mighty big stick, as Hacksaw Butch Reed will attest to. That incident has made wrestling news from coast to coast. I'm sure we're going to hear more from Master G. And ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with a great tag team wrestling match featuring the Mid-South Tag Team Champions right after this word from the Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
Hey, before you say anything, Mr. TV announcer, first, the boss man got something I want to say. Because you see, I want Master G down here, you understand? This sucker has done come out of nowhere. Only, who knows, I don't know where the fool come from. He got the first blood and on me. He done busted my hand.
We got something got for you, boy.
You draw the first blood. I want Master G down there, you understand?
We got something for you, boy.
Because we got some fun. I got a little suit.
Right here,
I got a little suit
that
I want this sucker to wear, you see? Because this is my yard. And he's talking about he's going to take over. He ain't taking over my yard. I run the bandit dude around out of his own doghouse, out of his own yard. I want Master G. Come on down here and face me, boy. I ain't going nowhere. I got all day. I'm going to be here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We don't have all day. This event, wrestling fans, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. On my left, from Salem, Virginia, Rick McCord. His team partner, 218 pounds, from Alabama, Steve Miller. And
hey, that thing. And now, I have the distinct privilege of introducing the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, lean, mean, slick and quick, Loverboy Dennis and beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express.
Mid-South. The Mid-South Tag Team Champions, Jim Cornette's Midnight Express, going against Rick McCord and Steve Miller. There's the bell. That signifies action. Referee Ron West will be our official in the ring for this particular bout.
Midnight Express. Bobby Eaton taking right over on Rick McCord now. Arm whip into the turnbuckles. Vicious elbow.
Rick McCord and Steve Miller, a young team, and they're going against what many experts say are the number one team in all of wrestling, the Midnight Express. They are the Mid-South Tag Team Champions. They have held that illustrious title for quite some time. And you can see by their teamwork that they have no wasted motion. They are like a well-oiled machine.
You know, Jim, they were great when they got here, and it seems to me like they have improved even more since working as a tag team here in the Mid-South.
Well, they have put PYT out of this area.
Rock and Roll Express.
They have put down all tag team comers. And here they are in Mid-South on our television program again, going against young Rick McCord and Steve Miller. And I'll say this, McCord and Miller certainly have their work cut out for them.
Oh, Dennis Condry dropped Rick McCord right over that top steel cable. And he has got to be hurting. Steve Miller yet to see any action.
There you see, Condry made the tag for McCord rather insultingly. That vicious backbreaker. Midnight Express so methodical. They're almost mechanical in their movements. As I mentioned, no wasted motion whatsoever.
Dennis Condry threw Steve Miller around like a big sack of wheat. He's going for that third backbreaker. He's punishing Steve Miller.
The tag was low. What a knee.
That was a high knee off the second rope. And, oh, that'll be all for Steve Miller. That will be all.
A tremendous victory for the Mid-South Tag Team Champions. And ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with Exotic Adrian Street right after this.
This event, one fall.
Hunter, I told you I got something I want to say.
And when say it.
I want you to know, Master Geckos, that I'm still here. Because you're a coward, boy. I'm down here ready for you to face me. You talk about how bad you are, and you're going to run me out of my yard. Boy, I'm from the Show Me State of Missouri, and you got to show me. You, Rick House Brown, come on down here, baby. I got something for you so you can look real natural. Come on, Master.
That's enough. That's enough. This event, one fall, or a 10-minute time limit. At 208 pounds from Birmingham, Alabama, Mike Jackson. Now we await the appearance of the exotic Adrian Street.
Individual with his valet and more specifically his servant, Miss Linda. I understand Miss Linda's family has been serving the family of Adrian Street for quite some time now. So I have been told that she is his servant, not only his valet, but his servant. So Miss Linda and exotic Adrian Street, and Street will be going against Mike Jackson.
You know, while Boyd was making the introduction, we saw the appearance of Nature Boy Buddy Landell and Hacksaw Butch Reed again there. It's kind of a nuisance. They seem to be bound and determined to give Master G what they call a feather suit.
Well, I tell you, from what I saw up close and personal last week of Master G, I don't think they're going to have to look too far to find him.
Mike Jackson. He's a little bit perplexed about Adrian Street's gyrations there.
The exotic one. Oh, yeah. Exotic Adrian Street. And, Joel, I'll be very frank with you. In my tenure here at Mid-South and watching other wrestling programs, I have never seen anything like the exotic one, Adrian Street.
Well, not only in wrestling, but in any form. The movies, television, I don't believe I've ever seen anybody quite as bizarre as this man right here. Very vicious man, too.
Well, exotic Adrian Street, don't let the packaging, if I may use that term, fool you. He is one tough customer. And under that blonde hair is two cauliflower ears, and you don't get that. You earn those, I must say.
Well, you notice there, Adrian Street's also a good tactician. He had, he kept putting Pee Wee Anderson out of the way. Mike Jackson with a big kick. Another big drop kick drops Adrian Street to the canvas. You know, Mike Jackson a lot of times is wrestling people where he's giving up a little bit of weight. Most of the time, a lot of weight. In this instance here, though, it'll be interesting to see what he can do against Adrian Street. Adrian Street going for a hip toss. Mike Jackson goes back with a reverse rear cup. He's got Adrian Street for a one count. Mike Jackson now continuing to work on that arm.
Adrian Street, though, showing just how vicious he is with those clubbing forearms. Hailing from the Royal Forest of Dean, exotic Adrian Street. Flying elbow, down goes Mike Jackson. Jackson with a right hand.
Oh, there's that European style forearm we've seen. Tremendous. Knocked Mike Jackson to the mat three times.
Streets got him up. An unusual variation. He's got him rolled over, pinning predicament. One, two, and three. Adrian Street continuing his winning ways here on Mid-South Wrestling. And ladies and gentlemen, we will be back with Tag Team Wrestling right after this word from the Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
This tag team event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit in the red corner. At 239 pounds, Dale Veazey. And his partner from North Carolina, Don Saunders. Across the ring, in the blue corner, their opponents, Miami, Florida, Brickhouse Brown. And at 230 pounds, from the state of Texas, Johnny Mantell. Your referee, Carl Fergie.
New tag team combination, Johnny Mantell and Brickhouse Brown going against Dale Veazey and Don Saunders here on Mid-South Wrestling. You heard ring announcer Boyd Pierce. The referee is Carl Fergie, and there's the bell.
You know, coming up, Jim, we've got our North American champion, Magnum TA, in a match against Art Cruz, and a match that I can't wait to see for the TV title, Terry Taylor against Hercules Hernandez. That should be a barn burner.
We certainly have a lot of action still coming your way, so don't go away, wrestling fans. Brickhouse Brown, a young man that has really taken the Mid-South area by storm. A man that came in here just a few weeks ago and introduced himself to Nature Boy Buddy Landell quite auspiciously. Great maneuver there, using the leverage. You know, Brickhouse Brown is one strong individual. He's not the biggest man, but he makes excellent use of his leverage. However, well, Veazey had him close to a pinning predicament at that point in time.
Jim, Brickhouse Brown is a very hard trainer. He hits the weights a lot. He's quite a determined young man. He wants to move up in the ranks.
Of course, his partner, the younger brother, the former junior heavyweight champion of the world, Ken Mantell, Johnny Mantell. It wrestling runs in their family, and he is a fine, fine young competitor. And Saunders with that cheap shot on Brickhouse Brown.
Carl Fergie caught him, though. You know, that time Carl was in position and could make the goal. Oh, oh, big flying body press by Brickhouse Brown. Tags into Johnny Mantell.
Johnny Mantell tried to drive Saunders through that mat with that body press, or that body slam.
Hit him with a big right hand, too. High flying back salto there.
There's a legal tag. Here comes Brickhouse.
Brickhouse with that powerful elbow.
Great maneuver by Brickhouse Brown. He's taking over on Saunders. You can see that momentum changing. And Brown is really taking over on Saunders.
Oh, kick! Drop.
Boy, he nailed him right in the jaw, that drop kick.
Brickhouse Brown has one of the finest, most well-executed drop kicks I've seen from any wrestler. And there's that Russian foot sweep, a side suplex, one, two, three, and that'll be all for Don Sun.
A great team victory for Brickhouse Brown and Johnny Mantell. And we'll be back with the North American Heavyweight Champion, Magnum TA, right after this.
This event, one fall.
Wait a minute, boy, Pierce. You see me standing here? Master G, I'm still down here standing tall in my backyard, sucker. Magnum T.A., you stand over there with that old skinny and grinning look on your face. I'll get to you. Don't you worry. But right now, I want a backstabbing, come sucker punch and dive turkey named Master Gutless. I want him right out in the middle of this ring. Boy, I got something for you to wear to make you look real natural. Ask the Junkyard Dog. He wore them before, and boy, look and look hard, because you next, you scared. You just like that old green that
dog. That's enough, that's enough. This event, one fall or 10-minute time limit. Introducing first in the red corner, from Topeka, Kansas, at 250 pounds, Art Cruz. And across the ring, 240 pounds, the North American heavyweight champion from Virginia Beach, Virginia, Magnum T.A. One fall, 10-minute time limit, a non-title match. Ron West, your referee.
Well, Hacksaw Butch Reed and Nature Boy Buddy Landell making a nuisance of themselves once again.
Jim, they are becoming kind of meddlesome there. They're determined to put Master G in a feather suit, it appears.
Well, feathers all over the ring. It's getting rather disgusting. They're interrupting the proceedings here on Mid-South Wrestling. But to the match at hand, the North American champion, Magnum T.A., and it's been one of the most exciting things in my career in wrestling is to watch the development of Magnum T.A. right here on Mid-South Wrestling, as so many stars have developed right here.
Well, Magnum T.A. was showing just then something he brought along with him from a long way back, some of that amateur background. He rode Art Cruz, and Art just went to the ropes. And now he's working on that arm of Art Cruz. Fireman's carry.
Right into that arm bar, Magnum T.A. As smooth an operator as ever stepped in the square circle. Tremendous condition, 240 pounds. And he has turned back the challenges of some of the toughest wrestlers. Great kip up by Art Cruz.
Art Cruz, you've got to remember, is a greatly improved wrestler himself.
He certainly is, and this is a great opportunity for that young man from Topeka, Kansas, to prove himself, because he's in there against the number one man, the North American champion. Cruz showed some great strength, but Magnum T.A. held right on to that arm.
You know, this is a non-title match, but Magnum T.A. has one of the nicest belts in wrestling, if not the nicest. 27 pounds of gold and silver on that thing, and I must say, if you get a chance to look at it up close sometime, any of you wrestling fans, it's really a sight to behold.
Well, I may be prejudiced. I think it's the most beautiful belt in all of wrestling, and of course, even though this match is a non-title match, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, a TV championship match, Terry Taylor the champion going against Hercules Hernandez. That's coming up next.
Magnum T.A. now continuing to put the pressure on that elbow. Art Cruz. Top wrist lock. Top wrist lock is a very painful hold. Tends to have a residual effect throughout a match.
Cruz tried to reverse it. Magnum T.A. did that, and right back to that now overhand wrist lock. And Cruz is in a pinning predicament. I'll say this, our officials in Mid-South Wrestling, the best you'll find anywhere, Ronnie West, Carl Fergie.
Well, Ronnie West was a little out of position there and missed Art Cruz pulling the hair. That's a tactic that a lot of folks pick up, putting that referee out of position, using that to his advantage.
Ooh!
Big right hand.
Magnum T.A. with another right hand, and now he's got Art Cruz reeling. Great drop kick! The North American champion opening up on Art Cruz.
Again with that forearm. Magnum T.A. has a belly-to-belly suplex.
And that's all. Belly-to-belly suplex, the winner of the match, the North American heavyweight champion, Magnum T.A. And ladies and gentlemen, don't you go away, because when we come back, it'll be the TV title match right after this.
this event for the Mid-South Television title. In the red corner, Hercules Hernandez, the challenger. Across the ring, Vero Beach, Florida, in the blue corner, Mid-South Television champion, Terry Taylor.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the Mid-South Television title. Referee Pee Wee Anderson calls for the bell. And Joel, we must mention here at the outset about the absence of the television medal.
Well, yes, I was talking to Terry Taylor about that earlier, and it seems that Dr. Death kind of abused the thing while he had it. It was all tarnished and beat up, and he's taking it to a jeweler, as proud of it as he is, and he's getting it refinished at this time.
This match is for the Mid-South Television Championship. One fall, 10-minute time limit, Terry Taylor, the champion, against the awesome challenge, Hercules Hernandez. And Taylor, flying body press.
Taylor just about made short work of Hercules Hernandez with that flying body press. Goes into a headlock. He really got good hip penetration, good execution out of that headlock. But I don't know with the strength of Hercules Hernandez whether he can pin him.
Pinning predicament, Hernandez. And Pee Wee Anderson in great position. Saw the pulling of the tights. Hercules Hernandez, a man that bench presses over 500 pounds. Without a doubt, if not the strongest, one of the strongest men in all of wrestling.
Well, the strong man's definitely facing a challenge now, but nice move tactically there.
Hernandez picked Taylor up, fell back with him, and now Terry Taylor is at a distinct disadvantage against the awesomely strong Hercules Hernandez.
For a reverse neck breaker.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I watch wrestling. Have a satellite dish and watch wrestling from all over the country on the cable, New York, wherever. The fans tell me, and I certainly agree with our fans, that New York wrestling and other wrestling in a lot of areas, so predictable, so many mismatches. No main event matches on television. Well, I can assure you, and I know you will agree, this match could be a main event anywhere. And you're seeing it right here on the number one wrestling television program in America, Mid-South Wrestling.
Hercules Hernandez with a rear chin lock on Terry Taylor now, trying to force the oxygen out of those lungs. He's got Terry Taylor in a lot of trouble. You know, a while back we saw him apply that reverse neck breaker, and you know, it's a good move for Hernandez because Terry Taylor suffered that severe neck injury a couple of months back, and things like that take a long, long time to heal.
And another thing, it really helps set your opponent up for that pet maneuver of Hernandez, that Shinanabaki. And that was a blatant hair pull. Hernandez maneuvered himself away from the referee and blatantly pulled the hair. You saw it.
You know, you mentioned the Shinanabaki. That's something that Terry Taylor, I'm sure, has definitely put a lot of thought preparation into because he must stay out of that hole.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have just been handed a note from matchmaker Grizzly Smith that Master G has accepted Hacksaw Butch Reed's challenge, and we're going to have that match, of course, barring any shortage of time. His only stipulation for Master G is that he wants it to be him and Reed one-on-one, and that means no Buddy Landale at ringside. So that is something to look forward to.
Big body slam. Hercules Hernandez went for the coup de grace, and Terry Taylor intelligently got out of the way. He's throwing those big right hands now. He's going to try and get right back at Hercules Hernandez. Reverse arm whip into the turnbuckle. Terry Taylor went for that cross body block and wiped out Pee Wee Anderson.
Well, Pee Wee Anderson, all 130 pounds perhaps of him, completely decimated.
Terry Taylor just leveled him. Hercules Hernandez, arm whip into the turnbuckle, and there's Terry Taylor with that big forearm. That big forearm.
Taylor's got him down.
Here comes, what's Dr. Death doing here?
Dr. Death has got that football helmet.
Here comes Carl Fergie trying to break it up.
Carl Fergie has entered the ring. They've called the disqualification.
That is a disqualification. He's setting Terry Taylor up. Terry Taylor gets it. Oh!
Doc hit Hernandez right in the midsection with that helmet, and that had to hurt.
Terry Taylor going to work. He's trying to take that helmet away from Dr. Death. But look out for Hernandez.
Hernandez caught him with that big size 12 right to the side of the head. And Terry Taylor is now in a severe predicament.
Doctor.
Oh, no.
Dr. Death using that football helmet as a weapon.
Grizzly Smith has better get some people down here to break this melee up, or Terry Taylor could be severely injured with that helmet. Yeah, there's Steve Miller. Steve Miller and Rick McCord have come to help out, but Doc just waylaid Steve Miller with that helmet. And Rick McCord goes over those top steel cables, and they're going back to work on Terry Taylor. Oh, my gosh.
Taylor suffered a laceration. They're beating Taylor with that helmet. We've got to have some help down in this ring. Terry Taylor, they're beating Taylor with that. Here comes Magnum T.A. Brickhouse and Johnny Mantell. The ring's filling up. The referees have disqualified Hercules Hernandez. The winner of this match by disqualification is Terry Taylor. And ladies and gentlemen, remember, Master G has answered a challenge, and we'll have Master G against Hacksaw Butch Reed, and that'll be coming up next.
This event,
hey,
one.
There you go again, boy piss.
Running off the mat.
Hey, Master G, the brick house, the real brick house is still standing here alive in his own backyard, you understand? And you better believe that it's my backyard. Now, boy, I done been beckoning you down here. I done insulted you to the maximum limit, you understand? I don't know what I got to do next. I guess that I got to come up there personally and grab you by your nappy hair
cold,
and pull you out of that dressing room and make you come down here and make you get on your knees and make you call me master, because I'm the real master here. You understand? I'm running the things here, and when I can't run things here, then it won't be no mess out, boy. Get down here, Master G. Master Goodness, get down here, boy. I heard about you talking to the dog. Did the dog tell you about how I used to dog him? Well, sucker, he didn't get nothing. He didn't get nothing.
Tell him, Butch.
He didn't get half of what you gonna
That's
get,
right.
boy.
We said it. We
understand?
Said it.
He didn't get half of what you gonna get. Get
Tell
down
him,
here, Master
Look
G,
here.
And
Look
pay
here.
Me homage.
Look here.
Pay me homage, boy.
Look here. Get on
he
your knees.
He split my head. He get split my knees, head boy. Wide open. He get drowned my blood. Come on down here, boy. Come on down here.
Wrestling fans, this match is one fall or television time remaining. From Kansas City, Kansas, Hacksaw Butch Reed. Now you've been mourning Master G.
Master G better be glad that Butch Reed's got him, because if I got him, I'd tear him apart.
He's not going to get him until you leave this ring.
I'm going to lay this tarred feather right over there, Butch, so we can feather him after you get through Destiny.
Stipulation that Buddy Landell leaves the ring, and then we'll see Master G.
Well, there you heard it.
To the M-A-S, a T-E-R, a G with a double E. I said I go by the unforgettable name of the man they call a Master G. Well, my name is known all over the world by all the foxy ladies and the pretty girls. I'm going down in history as the baddest rapper that ever could be. Now I'm feeling the highs and you're feeling the lows. The beat starts getting into your toe. You start popping your fingers and stomping your feet and moving your body.
Coming into the ring, all we know is from Oakland, California, Master G.
Well, Master G and Hacksaw Butch Reed, they're going right at it like two big stallions as they are. And Master G's taking over on Hacksaw.
It's toe-to-toe. There's a lot at stake here. Master G says he wants to make the Mid-South his yard now that Butch Reed has chased JYD off. They're going for broke.
Master G and Hacksaw Reed, they're laying the leather in.
Reverse arm whip into the turnbuckles.
Woo! What a clothesline!
Axel Butch Reed tried to get up, but he was spaghetti-legged from the impact of that big clothesline. And Master G now going to work on Hacksaw Butch Reed. What a stallion this Master G is.
Master G, he is big and he is bad, and he's taking it to Hacksaw Butch Reed.
In more ways than one, he could prove to be a real black eye for Hacksaw Butch Reed.
Reed with that powerful right hand. Master G is taking over on Reed. Wait a minute. There's Buddy Landell. Buddy Landell is coming to the ring. Referee Carl Fergie's calling for the bell.
Well, Buddy Landell just always has to get his 2 cents in.
Landell, the proponent of the cheap shot, and he's there. There you see Reed. Reed's going up. Reed's going up to the top.
Landell is holding Master G, but I don't know how long that can last. As whoa!
Reed with that slingshot, and he leveled Landell. Landell is out.
Master G with a big drop kick knocks Hacksaw Butch Reed through the second rope and out onto the concrete floor.
Reed is out on the concrete floor. He almost went through the barricade. Master G follows him out.
And he put him through the barricade, Jim.
He planted Hacksaw Reed on that barricade.
He has got that sticky, nasty substance, and he's going after Buddy Landell with it. Looks like it might be a feather suit. He can't get the top off. He just breaks it off. He just broke that top off. And now he's spreading that stuff all over Buddy Landell, who is practically unconscious from that forearm off the second rope from the huge Hacksaw Butch Reed.
There's going to be a suit, all right. There's going to be a feathering. Look at Landell, Master G. He's big and he's bad, and he does what he says, and he is feathering Nature Boy Buddy Landell.
And the Nature Boy learns a big lesson.
Ladies and gentlemen, unbelievable action, Master G. And I know we're going to see more of Master G in the future. Well, Matchmaker Greeley Smith negotiating for some more matches with this awesome individual.
We're also going to see more of the Rock and Roll Express. And we've got a video that I did quite some time ago to Jump by Van Halen.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, for Joel Watson and ring announcer Boyd Pierce, the Rock and Roll Express are coming back. Let's see them now.
See what I mean.
everybody, and welcome to this week's edition of Mid-South Wrestling. I'm your host, Boyd Pierce, and as always, the most intriguing sport in the whole world right here on Mid-South, because there's no way you can ever see what's going to happen. It just happens, and I'll tell you, it's something else, and this week is no different. You'll see Hacksaw Jim Duggan in action, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express, against Master G and Brickhouse Brown. Terry Taylor, the Mid-South Television Champion, will be on the card. Another tag team, Magnum TA, joins forces with Sonny King against Hercules Hernandez and Dr. Death Steve Williams. And from Australia, you'll see superstar Bill Dundee. A lot of things have been happening, and let me tell you something, friends. A large controversy has been swirling around Jim Cornette and the fines. He's carried it to the board of directors of Mid-South Wrestling, and no person in this world can bring us up to date than our guest commentator and the president of Mid-South Sports, Bill Watts. Bill?
Well, thank you, Boyd. Yes, it has been a very troublesome thing. 3 weeks ago, one of the most distasteful incidents I ever saw happened here on Mid-South Wrestling when they were signing a no disqualification title match for the Mid-South Tag Team titles. And the more we reviewed the films, the more we could see that Cornette and the Midnight Express had planned just exactly what they were going to do to the Fantastics. And Cornette took our new rules and regulations where we barred a two before. We barred a tennis racket, a steel chair, and a steel chain. But his lawyers found legalese or terminology or loopholes. He threatened lawsuits, and we said we're going to wait 2 more weeks to make a decision. Well, Cornette, I want to say one thing to you. There comes a time when everybody's got to stand up for what's right, even though it may not be written just perfectly. And Mid-South's not going to back down from anybody or anything. We are instituting a fine. We are fining you the largest fine in history, $30,000, $10,000 for each man, you, Cornette, and Eaton. And there is no more hearing about it. The money has already been collected, but Cornette has made some strong statements and ultimatum. Let's listen as Jim Ross interviewed him today before the show.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you have heard, the Midnight Express, Jim Cornette, Bobby Eaton, and Dennis Condrey have not been fined $10,000, but they have been levied a fine by Mid-South of $30,000, the biggest fine in the history of professional wrestling. At this time, Mr. Cornette has something to say.
All right, let me say this. It is not the fine that concerns me, $30,000, because I called home to mother, and even she had to ask what I was going to do with $30,000. But when I told her that Bill Watts was behind it, she agreed to send it immediately. It's not the fine that bothers me, because I also could have the fine overturned with my attorneys, because they are the best in the world. But I know that that bald-headed, pot-bellied, sway-backed, broken-down old ex-cowboy, Cowboy Bill Watts, is behind this whole thing, because I have my spies, too. He pushed it through the board of directors. So I don't want to have the fine overturned. I want humiliation from Bill Watts. I want Bill Watts, within 2 weeks, to bring me my check for $30,000 back on national TV and give me a public apology, or elsewise, Bill Watts, I'll hit you and Mid-South Wrestling right between the eyes. Dennis Condrey and Bob Eaton, the Midnight Express, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, will leave Mid-South, and we will not defend those tag team belts here ever again. Then what will you do, Mr. Smarty Pants? Then what will you do without the Tag Team Champions? 2 weeks! Or we're gone.
Well, Jim Cornette, nobody has ever intimidated Mid-South or make us back down. And I assure you, 2 weeks from today, we will make no apology and offer you no check back. Now let's go to the ring and Jim Ross for our first great bout.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match on Mid-South Wrestling is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. First, introducing at 250 pounds from Atlanta, Steve Brinson. His opponent at 275 pounds from New York, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Steve Brinson from Atlanta, Georgia, against the human Hacksaw from New York State, Jim Duggan. Bill?
He's even got a shirt on that certainly typifies my feelings. It's got a big wimp buster with Cornette's picture on front, and he says, "I ain't afraid of no wimp." And that's just exactly how Mid-South feels, too. If that's the way it is, we're going to be wimp busters. As Duggan ties up collar and elbow with Steve Brinson, forces him into the ropes, and referee Pee Wee Anderson calls for a break. Another tie-up, and then you see in the background the flags of the Mid-South area, Mississippi, Texas, Arkansas, Louisiana, and Oklahoma, the most exciting, unpredictable area in the world and wrestling. You know, we get phone calls from all over the country, and the fans even have set up an underground that trades off cassettes of the Mid-South videotape, and they say it's the greatest wrestling in the world, and there you see why, an explosive dynamo. Hacksaw Jim Duggan in there with a big youngster, Steve Britson. As you can see, we've added another camera, a handheld camera that's going to take you right in the ring for a lot of this excitement. We're excited about it. Collar and elbow again by Duggan and Brinson. Both men feeling each other out. Brinson certainly knows the reputation. Oh, he slapped. He slapped the hacksaw. Whoa, man. Boy, I'm telling you, you may as well hit him with a blackjack and slap him, because Hacksaw Duggan, he's a proud man. He's the man that had a marshmallow roast here with all the fans with Crusher Khrushchev's Russian flag. And these fans love him. Tremendous hip toss. And the hack goes for a high knee drop. And Steve Britson's finding out what it's like to face one of the tough studs formerly of the NFL, Atlanta Falcons, Canadian League, former All-American and SMU State High School Wrestling Champion, New York State. First chin lock, Brinson using that elbow, trying to break it loose. Duggan forearm smash. That's legal, and it's effective. Big Hacksaw Duggan. Brinson again trying to force his way out. Whoa, Duggan's got him up. Power slam. Duggan arm whips it into the turnbuckle. Clothesline. There goes Jimbo. He's getting ready to set for that spear into that three-point stance. He stalks his man. Brinson turned around on Groggy Street. And Hacksaw Jim Duggan just leveled him.
One, two, three, and Steve Brinson will long remember the time that he slapped Jim Duggan. Hacksaw is the victor. We'll be back after this word from Mid-South.
Last 2 weeks ago, a startling newcomer appeared. Master G said he came here to whip Hacksaw Butch Reed and proceeded to do so. But Reed has met a lot of challenges before, and he and Buddy Landell last week kept challenging Master G and said they were going to put a feather suit on him. Master G answered that challenge. Let's join that now.
Into the ring, all he knows is from Oakland, California, Master G.
Well, Master G and Hacksaw Butch Reed, they're going right at it like two big stallions as they are, and Master G's taking over on Hacksaw.
It's toe-to-toe. There's a lot at stake here. Master G says he wants to make the Mid-South his yard now that Butch Reed has chased JYD off. They're going for broke.
Master G and Hacksaw Reed, they're laying the leather in.
Reverse arm whip into the turnbuckles.
Woo! What a clothesline!
Hacksaw Butch Reed tried to get up, but he was spaghetti-legged from the impact of that big clothesline. And Master G now going to work on Hacksaw Butch Reed. What a stallion this Master G is.
Master G, he is big and he is bad, and he's taking it to Hacksaw Butch Reed.
In more ways than one, he could prove to be a real black eye for Hacksaw Butch Reed.
Reed with that powerful right hand. Master G is taking over on Reed. Wait a minute. There's Buddy Landell. Buddy Landell is coming to the ring. Referee Carl Fergie's calling for the bell.
Well, Buddy Landell just always has to get his 2 cents in.
Landell, the proponent of the cheap shot, and he's there. There you see Reed. Reed's going up. Reed's going up to the top.
Landell is holding Master G, but I don't know how long that can last. As
whoa! Reed with that slingshot, and he leveled Landell. Landell is out.
Master G with a big drop kick knocks Hacksaw Butch Reed through the second rope and out onto the concrete floor.
Reed is out on the concrete floor. He almost went through the barricade. Master G follows him out.
And he put him through the barricade, Jim.
He planted Hacksaw Reed on that barricade.
He has got that sticky, nasty substance, and he's going after Buddy Landell with it. Looks like it might be a feather suit. He can't get the top off. He just breaks it off. He just broke that top off. And now he's spreading that stuff all over Buddy Landell, who is practically unconscious from that forearm off the second rope from the huge Hacksaw Butch Reed.
There's going to be a suit, all right. There's going to be a feathering. Look at Landell, Master G. He's big and he's bad and he does what he says, and he is feathering Nature Boy Buddy Landell.
And the Nature Boy learns a big lesson.
Ladies and gentlemen, unbelievable action, Master G. And I know we're going to see more of Master G in the future. Well, Max Maker Greeley Smith negotiating for some more matches with this awesome individual.
Well, boy, Master G not only answered the challenge, but he dressed Buddy Landell in his own feather suit. One of the most exciting, thrilling moments I've ever seen on Mid-South. Let's go to the ring now, Jim Ross, for this next great bout.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match on Mid-South Wrestling is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. First introducing in the red corner, weighing 231 pounds from Los Angeles, California, Nature Boy Buddy Landell. His opponent from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing 220 pounds, Rocky Smith.
One fall, 10 minute now, the California Nature Boy Buddy Landell against Rocky Smith from Nashville, Tennessee. Ron West, the referee, and calls for the bell.
Well, Buddy Landell must have had a hard time getting that goo and mess out last week, but he sure had a beautiful robe on tonight, and the audacious, unflappable Nature Boy Buddy Landell, the man who said he's trained Hacksaw Butch Reed, and if you believe that, you believe in a lot of strange things, because Butch Reed is a powerful, powerful athlete and a very self-starting motivator. Side headlock. Rocky Smith. Nature Boy Buddy Landell. A lot of exciting, unpredictable things here on Mid-South Wrestling. I think that's why I love the sport so much. Good move by Rocky Smith, and he went for a drop kick. Didn't get too high there. Went for it twice, and Landell, I'll tell you one thing about Landell. He is one of the most improved athletes in Mid-South Wrestling, and you can't take his confidence. He'll get whipped, and he'll come right back and try the guy again next week. I've never seen anybody like that. Generally, guys like that, they get stuck that bad, don't want no more. But Buddy Landell seems to just come right in. And this crowd, they really are taunting Buddy Landell about Master G. Buddy Landell started picking on Brickhouse Brown, you remember, and Brickhouse Brown whipped him good. Landell seems to run sticky nose in everybody's, but he wants to be the kingpin so bad. It wouldn't surprise me one bit to see him double-cross Butch Reed one day, because Butch Reed is his idol, but also Butch Reed's in the position that Buddy Landell wants. Reverse elbow, snap mare. Landell's on top. He's covering that Rocky Smith like a blanket. Front face lock. Referee Ronnie West, I think one of the finest referees in wrestling today. Maneuverable, he tries his best to stay in position, to call it as he sees it. With these tacticians you have in the ring, that's practically an impossibility. They know every way to feint the referee out of position so that they can break the rules. But Buddy Landell is explosive, tremendous form, and Rocky Smith is really feeling the power of what it's like to come to Mid-South, as have so many. Landell raked his eyes, Ronnie West warning him. There's little he can do about it except a warning. First elbow by Landell. Body slam. Landell, the audacious one. And he power drops that elbow. He really slams it in there. 1, 2, 3.
There you have it, Nature Boy Buddy Landell, hand raised in victory. Master G and Big House Brown against the Midnight Express when we return on the exciting Mid-South Wrestling.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, this tag team match is one fall with a 10-minute time limit.
Wait just a second. Let me introduce to you now, you lucky people who get to see the most awesome combination in wrestling. Still the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, still the best, regardless of the efforts to try and take it away in the ring and in the courtroom. Loverboy Dennis and beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express.
Tag team match is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. And now please welcome Master G and Brickhouse Brown.
I said I go by the unforgettable name of the man they call the Master G. Well, my name is known all over the world by all the foxy ladies and the pretty girls. I'm going down in history as the baddest rapper that ever could be. Now I'm feeling the highs and you're feeling the lows. The beat starts getting into your toe. You start popping your fingers and stomping your feet and moving your body while you're sitting and you're sitting. Then damn,
ladies and gentlemen, introducing at 225 pounds from Miami, Florida, Brickhouse Brown. His partner weighs 255 pounds from Oakland, California, Master G.
Master G and Brickhouse Brown being introduced by Jim Ross. And earlier, the Midnight Express, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, having been introduced by their manager, Jim Cornette, along with his ever-present bodyguard, Hercules Hernandez. Paul Fergie called for the bell, signifying one man from each team. It's Bobby Eaton and Brickhouse Brown, Hughesville.
Well, I might say, Boyd, that this was a standing ovation for Brickhouse Brown and Master G. These are two that have really captured the hearts of the fans here in Mid-South. Collar and elbow by the Brickhouse and Bobby Eaton, but they're against the best team that has ever dominated tag team wrestling in Mid-South, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, under the auspices of Jim Cornette, who has delivered a scalding ultimatum to Mid-South, and his bodyguard, Hercules Hernandez. Brickhouse Brown, quick movement out there. You're gonna see some speed out there tonight, I definitely believe. Bobby Eaton caught one. Brickhouse Brown, he is just exactly how he's built. He is a Brickhouse, and of course that's one. Oh, look at that drop kick. Listen to this place. The Irish McNeil Boys Club is jam-packed tonight. You can hear the excitement, it just curls through you. Carl Fergie, referee. There you see Hercules Hernandez, always watchful of Cornette's back, keeping his eye open for one person, primarily, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
All right, clap now, Bobby, come on,
Bobby. Oh, these men are straining now for the advantage in this tie-up. Testing the hand and arm strength. The Brickhouse does a little boogie. What a quick move! And a quick body. Oh! Boy, I'll tell you, I'm as excited as everybody here.
Bill, with all the great wrestlers here and the referee.
Oh, look at him. He's ripping Master G's hair right off. I don't know. Master G, though, it's right up. Excuse me, boy. I didn't.
That's
look
all
at
right. Him. I tell
you. Look at these body slams. Master G slammed them. Three times. Wow, flying head scissors.
That goes Tom.
And he's right back to his feet. What an athlete.
And Bobby Eaton, and like you said, Bill, exciting. And now with our handheld camera, the exciting Mid-South wrestling is more exciting Mid-South wrestling.
Oh, listen to Cornette. Cornette is really worried. He is really worried. Underarm bar. Tag in the Brickhouse. You think this tag team situation is not going to get all clouded? Fantastic. In 2 weeks, the Rock and Roll Express will be back. And now you got Brickhouse and Master G. But you again see why they're the Mid-South Tag Champions. As he went high-flying to propel Condry out, Eaton held his partner in the corner, causing Brickhouse to fall backwards on his head. That's that teamwork that has made them maintain the Mid-South Tag Team Championships. Makes them such an awesome team. They've never wrestled single matches, only tag team. And they generally figure some way to get it down 2-1. Wow. Salto. He's got him wrapped up. There he goes. It looked like he had him. Brickhouse's tremendous strength reserve allowed him to kick out of that cradle. Tag is made. Dennis Condrey. Condrey in. See how quick and how vicious they are. Oh, back-breaking type move on the side rib cage. Even more devastating. And then he quickly follows it up, driving the knees into the jaw and neck area of the Brickhouse. Bobby Eaton quickly in. They team in so quick. They're so fast. Armbar. Brickhouse is fighting. He's trying to get out of there. He knows he's in a lot of trouble. He needs to get over to the Master G. That's just what the man's name is, Master G. If he can get to Master G, cause a lot of trouble. Oh, these guys, really, what a collision. What a collision. Bobby Eaton trying to make a tag. Master G calling for Brickhouse to come to the tag. Bobby Eaton quickly, he tagged Condrey. The Brickhouse didn't make the tag. Brickhouse is still stuck in there with Dennis Condrey. Cornette pulled the top rope down. Cornette pulled that top rope as we saw him do once before. With Robert Gibson, one of his favorite maneuvers. Brickhouse is down. They're all in there. Master G is cleaning out. Master G is cleaning out. Butch Reed in the ring. Ernie Ladd's in the ring. Ernie Ladd's in the ring now. Nature Boy Buddy Landell, they're all on Master G. Butch Reed's got a belt.
He has a belt, man.
He's going to whip him. Butch Reed's going to whip him. Butch Reed's laying the leather to him. Master G is so mad, he's still, even five of them can't hold him, boy. Master G is so mad about it, he can't be held. But there's too much horsepower. Too much horsepower. Buddy Landell is whipping him. That's the worst that's in the world. Nature Boy Buddy Landell. They're whipping Master G.
Ernie Ladd and Butch Reed is holding him.
Reed and Ladd are holding him, and Landell is beating him. And he's beating him back. Here comes Dugan. Here comes Terry Taylor, Magna T.A., Sonny King. Pandemonium, boy. Pandemonium.
As we try to slow things down and get back to normal, we'll be right back after this word from the exciting Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. You know, we talk about exciting. Not everything exciting is nice and right. As you just saw the belt thrashing that Buddy Landell put on Master G. But Lou, I have to notice that Hacksaw Butch Reed and the Big Cat Ernie Ladd was holding Master G. Bill Watts has gone to check on his condition. Right now, Terry Taylor, the Mid-South Television Champion, will be in the next match. And the exotic Adrian Street has asked to be our guest commentator because next week here on Mid-South, he will face Terry Taylor.
I just can't wait to get my hands on him, just to prove. You know, I don't think, much to their own disgrace, I don't think that the fans or the promotions in this area have been taking me as seriously as they should. I'll have you know that I have been the heavyweight champion of all of Europe on 4 different occasions. I've never lost a title. Whenever I go off on my travels like I'm here, I simply abdicate with the understanding that I get the first chance to regain the title I've abdicated in Europe on my return.
Well, you can show us your knowledge of wrestling because we're going to the ring and you describe the next match for the folks at home.
I'd love to.
This match on Mid-South Wrestling is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. First introducing in the red corner at 220 pounds from Montgomery, Alabama, Jason Walker. Making his way to the ring area at 232 pounds from Vero Beach, Florida, your Mid-South Television Champion, please welcome Terry Taylor.
As the introduction in the black tights, Jason Walker taking on the television champion of the Mid-South area, Terry Taylor. Here's the man who will meet him next week right here on Mid-South Wrestling, exotic Adrian Street.
Listen to that awful noise. You can jump to yourself, think. all those silly wrestling fans screaming and squeaking. He's taking him a good takedown now. Cross buttock. He's got a good grip on that man's head, but I don't think he'd hold me for that long. In actual fact, I don't think he'd get me in that position in the first place. Very good. Now, in the Admiral Lord Mount Evans style of wrestling, which is far superior to anything you'll see in this ring for this match, when he had him in that position on the ground, he hooked his other arm and really tied him up. But I tell you, I've got things that I'm going to show Terry Taylor that he'd never heard of. Yes, as I said, I simply can't wait to get my hands on Terry Taylor. He makes a very pretty picture now, but by the time I'm finished with him, he looks like a jigsaw puzzle with half the pieces missing.
Well, you folks that might have just tuned in, the Exotic Asian Street talking about his match next week against the Mid-South Television Champion, Terry Taylor, in the red tights. Right now, he's taking on Jason Walker.
He's taking a bit of a pounding there, too. Oh, that, I must say, that was a beauty. But he might catch Jason Walker with something like that. But you'll never, ever, ever, you'd have to get up early in the morning to catch Exotic Adrian Street with something like that.
It was a beauty and a victory for Terry Taylor. Thank you, Adrian Street, and we'll be back. Tag team action after this word from Mid-South Wrestling.
This is Tag Team Wrestling on Mid-South, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. First introducing in the red corner, at 260 pounds, he hails from Bad Street, Hercules Hernandez. His partner at 276 pounds, Oklahoma University, Steve Dr. Death Williams. Ladies and gentlemen, their opponents at 252 pounds, McCall, Louisiana, Sonny King. And his partner at 240 pounds, the North American heavyweight champion, Virginia Beach, Virginia, Magnum PA.
How do you like your tag team action? You'll probably see it in this match. Don't go away as Sonny King and Magnum TA pair up against the rugged duo of Hercules Hernandez and Dr. Death Steve Williams. Ron West called for the bell, wanting one man from each team. Here's Bill, and he's ready.
Oh boy, I'm telling you, that's the pandemonium here. Magnum TA tries to get a quick fall. Look how quick these big men are. These are 250 pounders. Right, they're moving it. I mean, they're moving it. This is awesome, actually. What excitement has been today here on Mid-South. You know, I was just in the dressing room seeing about Master G, and they're having to put salve in those open wounds. He is laced on his back, badly lacerated. That was, he said, the worst beating he's ever taken in his life. He said not even his daddy or his mama ever strapped him like that. North American champion, Japanese arm drag. And Hercules Hernandez is wanting some time. He says, wait a minute. And you've got Steve Dr. Death Williams, 280 pounds out there. And you see the Dr. Death Award that he carries with him at all times, that football helmet hanging on the ring post. Of course, some bad blood between Dr. Death and Hacksaw Dugan, who was a great football star in his own right. Yes! Tried to back T.A. into the corner. T.A. is so quick. He just gained so much in stature. That tremendous confidence given him since winning that North American title and defeating all comers. And you see Sonny King. Sonny King has got a bone to pick of his own in here in this match, because Hercules Hernandez is a man who damaged him badly with that two before that caused us to enact the ruling that has now resulted in a $30,000 fine, the largest fine in history for Jeff Cornette and his crew. Arm whips by Sonny King. Snap there. And Sonny King laying him on the thick Dr. Death. Wow. I'm telling you, the fans here, Boyd, it's been people on the top of their toes with the excitement here at the Irishman Neal Boys Club. tremendous wrestling card. I've seen wrestling from other parts of the country. They got a lot of big name stars and big arenas, but you don't have the fast-paced action that is so trademarked by Mid-South Wrestling. You got the big men, and they move constantly. They don't get out there and stalk around and walk around and get a hold and just lay in it. They are out there trying to beat somebody, and I think that's what makes wrestling the king of sports. Sonny King, and he's trying to tear Hercules Unchained's arm right out of the socket to repay him for that dislocated shoulder. But Hercules Hernandez is so powerful. Truly one of the most awesome specimens I've ever seen. Bench press is 525 pounds. And he is from Bad Street, I'll tell you. Ronnie West calling the action. Sonny King, a kick to the solar plexus. Bad Street fires back. 2 weeks, Boyd will have the Rock and Roll Express back. Kicked by Sonny King, tag into the North American champion. Next week, Terry Taylor faces Adrian Street for that TV title. And look at this, what action! Magnum didn't even let him get up. He drop kicked him right on his knees. T.A. is a tremendous champion. Tag is made behind T.A. I don't think T.A. saw it. He didn't see it. And as he leaped over, Hercules Hernandez, Dr. Death was there to meet him with that 280 pounds that blocked Billy Sims and Marcus Dupree to All-American fame in college football. Dr. Death punishing Magnum T.A. Doc is determined to make a reputation for himself in the Mid-South area, and he has fast climbed to the top of the chart. Clothesline, and T.A., the North American champion, in a lot of pain right now. Bear hug. Doctor has him up in a bear hug. An excruciating, painful hole. You see his hands locked just beneath the rib, where it really cut in on the lung power. Tag is made. And the Hercules Hernandez follows that bear hug right up. These men have become a feared team. Probably the most powerful team ever in the Mid-South area. They've become devastating winners. Sonny King made the tag. The referee didn't see it. The referee never saw the tag. Sonny King had made the tag, but the referee didn't see it. Mike and T.A.'s got Hercules Hernandez. He's got him rolled up. Dr. Death just popped him with that helmet. Dr. Death just popped him with a helmet. Dr. Death popped him with a helmet, and Hercules Hernandez and Dr. Death are the winners. The referee was out of position. That shows you what tremendous tacticians these men are. They take advantage of the slightest mistake on anybody's part. No blame on the referee. These guys are just awesome.
Bill, we have more action coming up. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this word from the exciting Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match on Mid-South Wrestling is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. First introducing in the red corner at 218 pounds, Salem, Virginia, Rick McCord. His opponent weighs 205 pounds. He is from Melbourne, Australia, superstar Bill Dundee.
Rick McCord from Salem, Virginia, against the man from Melbourne, Australia, down under and out back. The superstar of wrestling, Bill Dundee, as Paul Fergie called for the bell.
Now, boy, this match shouldn't be quick. It should be sudden. Both these men, very quick. Superstar Bill Dundee. Well, he got caught right there, but he's got a reputation that precedes him that is awesome. He has wrestled all over the world, and he's wrestled them all sides. And Dundee says, against the big guys, you just got to do a little more figuring, and you got to really be quick on your feet, because he said you can't stand still and take them head on. Of course, we've seen Dr. Death and Hercules Hernandez and Magnum T.A. and Sonny King moving like junior heavyweights with all their size and quickness. And this is a trademark on Mid-South. Butch Reed is so quick to be so big. Everybody moves, but Dundee is tremendously fast. But Rick McCord right now got him in a hammerlock. And he's punishing him. Dundee reverses it, pushes him into the corner. Whoa! To Dundee. Dundee's a feisty little guy. He's got a, I get such a kick at him, great accent. And he's cocky, I'll tell you, he's cocky to the bone, but he's a good wrestler. He'll put moves on some of these people that you just haven't seen. Mid-South has gone out and we've gotten all sizes wrestlers because we think the people want to see the complete panorama of wrestling. We don't want just the great big giants, we want them all sizes. The quickness, the mixture, it creates so much excitement. Oh, look at that move. Boy, you just got to let the fans
alone. Bill, I just thought he'd made a bad maneuver, and it turned out he was on top of the situation.
Well, I tell you, you know, you don't get an international reputation without being somebody, just like Adrian Street. People that just don't know how to take him yet, but I'm telling you one thing. Like you said, he's got those cauliflower ears under that, all that pansy-like dress and hair, and he has been the four-time European champion, and he hadn't been beat. He's just left to go on tour. So you, when you've got a guy like that, you know he's tough. And next week here on Mid-South, Adrian Street meets Terry Taylor for the television title. We'll be able to see, and the fans at home will be able to judge. Also next week, a fantastic tag match because you have the Fantastics in it against Hercules Hernandez and Steve Dr. Death Williams. And then 2 weeks, right here on television, the Rock and Roll Express. And I know everybody is just at the edge of the seat, and they're looking forward to this team because this team really excited the fans in the Mid-South. Everybody's been waiting 90 days, to be exact, to see what they do to the Midnight Express. Dundee, so quick. Shot by Rick McCord. He's driving Dundee's head into a turnbuckle. Reverse elbow on McCord. Elbow drop. Dundee's finding out also that the competition here in Mid-South is double tough. And your reputation doesn't mean anything when you come in this door. The only way you're going to earn it in Mid-South is earning the ring. But when you earn it in Mid-South, the whole world knows about it. Because, again, the inside talk in all the wrestling industry is, if you want to prove yourself, go to the Mid-South. That's where the toughest, most intensive competition is. Whoa, power slam! Rick McCord barely got out. Oh, Dundee must have played a little soccer down there in Australia because you could hear that kick resounding. Dundee, sleeper hold. He's caught a sleeper on Rick McCord. Now let me tell you, I don't care how tall or how big you are, that sleeper will put you down because it cuts the blood off from the carotid arteries to the brain. And I don't care if you're Andre the Giant, if it's cut off, you're gonna go bye-bye. And there you see Rick McCord, and he stayed in it a little too long, and Dundee really has it wrapped tight. It's rumored that he's an expert.
And with the sleep hole, the Australian superstar of the world, Bill Dundee, takes a victory over Rick McCord, and we'll be back following this word from Mid-South Wrestling. Exciting, intriguing, and unpredictable. You've seen it all this week on Mid-South Wrestling. Next week, the Mid-South Television Championship will be on the line as you see Terry Taylor take on the exotic Adrian Street. Tag team action, the Fantastics versus Hercules Hernandez and Steve Dr. Death Williams. Bill?
That's right, and in 2 weeks, live and in living color, the Rock and Roll Express. And right now, let's join them in Rock and Roll is King by the Electric Light Orchestra as we say goodbye for another exciting hour of Mid-South Wrestling.